Hi guys, welcome back to Yeki's Corner. With me here today is Mr. Eliasu Ibrahim, also known as Ogailia.
No, I don't know about that Ogailia part. My name is Ibrahim Eliasu.
Ogailia. Okay, so welcome to my channel and thank you for agreeing to be here.
It's a pleasure to be here.
Let's play a game first.
Okay.
I have some words here.
Okay.
You pick one. Read out the word and sing a song that has that word in it.
And if I don't know the song, that's how I get to lose the game. No, I'm not losing. Let's go.
So who picks first?
Ladies first. Go ahead.
Okay. Yeah. Move. By Lamborghini.
No, I don't know. There's no song like that.
There is.
There's no song like that.
Serious, there's a song.
I've never, all my life, I've been around for some time. All my life, I've never heard a song like what you just sang.
There's a song. He released it last month or 2 months ago, Lamborghini.
How am I supposed to know a song that was released 2 months ago?
Check Lamborghini on Instagram.
How am I supposed to know a song that was released 2 months ago? I really don't believe you, but fine.
I'm serious.
No, it's okay. Fine, let's go. And the word that I have here is baby. Baby, wala kulungu. Baby, wala kulungu. Oh, I love my money. You know that song, right?
Yes.
But this way, fine. So that's I put a point.
Ego. If you help me see Ego, make you tell him I don't
know. Okay. That one is cheating. Let me see what's going on. This is forever. Forever. I know songs forever. I just can't find it right now. Wherever you go. Do not say yes when you mean to say no. Forever, wherever you go.
Yes.
Yes, yes, that's what you say, yeah.
No, the song you're singing is wherever.
No, there's a different version. You never heard that version. You never heard the version. Forever, wherever you go.
Guys, is it true?
That's the last one.
Yes. Woman. My woman. My everything.
That's simple. I know a song that has woman in it.
What's the song?
Woman, take me in your arms.
97.
Rock me, baby. Yes, I was around. In case you didn't notice, I was around.
Okay. So talking about woman, let's talk about my gender. Recently, there was a story about a girl who was looking for a job. I don't know if you heard about it.
Yeah, I did.
And was murdered. That got me thinking, like, I don't feel my gender is safe, you know. Even when you go to the market, example, Wuse market, you see the guys there selling things, pulling your hands, drawing you, calling you my love, you know, and all that.
My color.
I feel like being a woman is scary. Yeah, so what do you think about all this?
Yes, you're very correct, you know, that essentially it looks to me like a woman has become an endangered species. We can talk about security or insecurity generally, and then we're looking at it and saying we're feeling like, oh, it affects everybody, yeah. Because I mean, only recently, I knew a friend whose 21-year-old son simply stepped out to go and use the POS machine and get some cash, and he was missing for a week, and for that. But the family just managed to get him back recently, you know, and things like that. Very battered, and they injured him badly and was badly beaten and all of that. So, but despite the fact that it looks like it's a general problem, when you particularly look at what the woman is more exposed to, it's bad. But by the way, sorry, I just wanted to make this like a side observation view, you know, around the lady that went for a job interview and things like that, you know. It's sad. I think that a lot of people failed that girl. But generally speaking, a lot of girls are exposed to all kinds of things that, you know, they don't deserve it. You know, they don't deserve it. It stems from the other example you're giving about those boys in Wuse market who feel that they can just touch you. It stems from a sense of entitlement. Unfortunately, that you know, male children seem to be brought up with that sense of entitlement. it feel like, you know, she's just a woman now. I can just, you know, just to touch her, what is her problem and things like that. Because some of them in that was like I've noticed, even when you complain, they actually look back at you and throw, want to throw insults at you, you know, and all of that, you know. So, but hey, it's a bad world we're living in, you know? And it's the world we're living in is getting more and more dangerous. And it's even more dangerous, you know, for the female, for the girl child. It's almost like now, by default, everybody's trying to tell the girl child to be careful, and nobody's telling society not to, you know, endanger the girl child, you know, and things like that. There's several of it happening. The last time I saw the pictures on social media about those three university students, Greenwood, I think that's invested, they went in Kaduna and they were killed. You know, it was so sad when I noticed that at some point that, you know, the corpses of the girls, you know, they were already like almost nude. They were stripped of their clothes, they were, you know, so I started asking myself, but there was a male, one of them that was male, was his clothes were intact. So in my head I was like, you know, what did they do to these children even before they eventually killed them? You know, so when you hear just random, oh, there's been a kidnapping somewhere, people have been picked, you know, when a woman is involved in that, the danger for her is always a lot more. And society isn't, we're not talking about it enough, we're not like you're saying, we're not figuring it out. We just, you know, people just want to call numbers and say, these are the number of people that were picked, or number of people that were kidnapped. But you see, when you begin to analyze that this particular kidnap, how does that affect, you know, the people that were male in it, the people that were female in it differently? Then you begin to really see how brutal the world that we are living in now is becoming to, you know, to the female.
So let me go back to the lady who went for the job interview.
Yeah.
You know, like I read on Twitter and I saw on Instagram too that, you know, she told her friend about it. You know, sometimes when you're going out, they tell you, oh, dress in a certain way, or let somebody in your family or your friend know where you're going to and all that. And I learned that, you know, she told a friend about the interview. And, you know, she's going for an interview. I'm sure she wasn't dressed, you know, inappropriately and all that. She ticked, you know, the boxes, but still she was murdered. I keep wondering the kind of world we live in. And I am scared for myself. I have sisters, I have, you know, friends, female friends, I have my niece and all. So I wonder, you know, what does the future hold for the girl child?
I think that one of the most I don't know if it is scary or scariest, I don't know if the dying dish would exist, but one of the most scary moments of my life was there's a period, the long period where, you know, my 21-year-old, you know, daughter was first in his secondary school, somewhere on some express road, somewhere in between, you know. And every time that we had a chance to go there for visiting, I said, and I'm looking at the environment, and I every night I have this worry, like, because I could just tell that anybody could have just backed into that compound and picked all of those students away from that place. Then it didn't get any better. She was in secondary school, she's not completed the university course. And even the university, the first time I went to the campus, I kept on looking at the place, like, this place is sitting in the middle of nowhere, it's very vulnerable. But then she had to get a degree. So imagine that this is the context in which the girl child has. So the default context is that dangerous. And, you know, is that, yeah. And it's not necessarily about whether the girl even wore the arrival for the interview and things like that. People batter, rape, and end up, you know, killing babies. So from a baby, from the time the baby is in the cradle, if it's in your home, she doesn't want a job yet. She's not going out to find a job. She's just a baby, little baby girl, you know. If you are not careful, she's barely 5 years old, she's in her home, in your home, you know, somebody could, you know, be abusing her. Recently, we're doing some work and we went some IDP camps, and, you know, people just thought, oh, they have toilets. But a lot of the toilets were, there's not no closed systems, no water systems, nothing, you know, they just, yeah. So what it means is that if a young man is living in one or two, one of the rooms there, he wants to pee at night, he can just open his door and go pee at night. But you see, that interval where the lady moves from that room to go and, you know, ease herself, you know, and no matter how, you know, depending on how dead in night is a dangerous trick. And she just wanted to ease herself. And she can be exposed to something, you know, very dangerous and like, you know. But then if you do the analysis, you just say, oh, they have toilets, yeah, they have toilets, you know. So it's so when we try to solve any problem that we have in Nigeria, we are not factoring in that the fact that, you know, solutions may not necessarily be the same for the male and the female, you know, and things like that, you know. So it's very annoying to hear people say things like, oh, did she, because the question that comes up, in your own analysis, you know, we had to be saying, hey, it's an interview. She will not have dressed inappropriately. Why should she even be so worried? Why is it being a factor? The fact that we're actually discussing what she wore today, you know, is already showing that, you know, we have systems in this country that do not protect the females. I'm not sure what the solutions are, but I will feel like that sense of entitlement that, you know, the average male child seems to grow up with. And it's ironic that even when women bring up their sons, they seem to grow with that sense of entitlement. It almost feels like this is right. This person probably started saying, who's this one? Yeah, if she's looking for a job and putting, you know, maybe she put her picture, maybe because of that, he's now followed her account, you know, saw her pictures, and, you know, he just felt like that. She can't be looking, does she know, can she go somewhere else properly for, she must be looking for, you know, not knowing that this is just a girl who's desperate. I was looking for using any means available to her. Maybe she doesn't have the contact or whatever to know which jobs are where, or which companies are, you know, so she just felt, well, maybe if I have access to social media, if I just put out my skills and see this what I can do, maybe that would, you know, get me a job. But it got her killed. Again, that's a direct result of the fact that there are no jobs. And the girl was simply trying to do that. I mean, that's what got her desperate enough to pull up a link like that. She's finished school probably, she's been hanging out there and no jobs. And today she's, for taking that risk, she's lost her life, which is very sad. We don't have the morals to even say we are protecting, you know, the girl child, you know, the way we should. I feel like going back to the home may be a good solution. Let's not take it for granted, because again, even though I'm talking about bringing up children, sometimes I don't know where it comes from, but I just know that sometimes you find that whether it's the man in the wholesale market that touches you inappropriately, or is this man that sat down and conceived or thought up the idea of, you know, luring this girl into, you know, some building and taking advantage of her to the point of, you know, killing her, you know, all of this. There's a sense of entitlement. There's a sense of feeling like, you know, I can do this and I can, you know, it can happen and nothing will happen, essentially. You know, so we bring up male children that we need to be, I think the homes, we have to go back to the homes and see how we bring up male children, are we raising monsters? You know, why is it that, you know, the male child just feels like, you know, it's his entitlement. We will keep figuring it out as we keep talking about it over and over, maybe, you know. Yeah.
Yes, I also feel like, you know, it's not a one-off discussion. It's not even when you're looking for solutions to things like this, it's not just a one-off thing.
Yeah.
Thank you, Mr. Ibrahim, for coming on Yeki's Corner.
Thank you, Yeki. It was my pleasure to be here.
I learned a lot.
Yeah, same here.
And I hope you did. Thanks for watching. Remember to like, share, and subscribe. And leave a comment below. I want to know what you think about today's topic. Thanks, guys.